Good evening.
How are you all doing?
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Bailey. Thank you very much, all of you, being here this evening. And my heartfelt thanks to the Chamber, the Home Builders Association, the Valdosta Board of Realtors for putting this event together. And I'm truly proud of you, this three organization, for the heroic task you undertake each and every day to keep our community very, very productive. My hats off to you all. Well, you know, this morning I emailed asking Myrna whether it's 3 or 5 minutes. So I got an email back that it's going to be 5 minutes, now it's been 10 minutes. So Tom, can I borrow your students to clap some more for me? So, I'm Vikram Mohanty. I'm running for State Senate for the second time. How many of you were here in the last forum? Thank you. Thank you for making our democracy participatory. Last week, the Winn-Dixie store, actually it was last Saturday, they declared that they're going to close 2 stores right here in Valdosta. 130 people will lose their job and wouldn't know where else to go. Our city, Valdosta, and many surrounding towns has numerous challenges. Public school teachers and state employees haven't seen a raise in their paycheck for the last 7 to 8 years. Georgia is the last in job creation. My dear friends, the real question today is, is your life any better today than it was 2 years ago, 5 or 10 years ago? It's a very simple question. We know the answer to that question. However, I want you to know, I believe in my heart, Georgia's best days are still ahead. I believe in each and every one of you because I am one of you. I work 8 to 6, treat my patients, pay taxes, raising a family, taking care of my small business. Obviously, I'm not a politician. I'm a licensed and board certified occupational therapist. I proudly serve almost every hospital in South Georgia. Today, I'm here to speak to you from my heart. And I want to ask you, each of you, to evaluate my candidacy based on the principles and based on ability to take bold and courageous steps. And it is my sincere hope that you will look into the future and be able to tell your grandchildren and children my story. A candidate you put in the state capital who was able to take bold step, even if he stayed in the capital for 1 term. My opponent, on the other hand, is a good man, very good man. That's why I sat next to him. He's a career politician, with due respect, no doubt about that. The simple question we need to ask today, why electing him today to the Senate would be any better than it has been in the last 10 to 12 years. My dear friends, I have a very different story to tell. I passionately tell people I landed in this Valdosta with $50 merely in my pocket and the clothes in my back. In the last 12 to 15 years, I'm grateful to report to you that we have employed at least 170 people, not at the same time though. I graduated from high school without seeing electricity. I sold vacuum cleaners in the street of Calcutta. I sold paper bags to pay for my tuition. Then in my college days, I had the opportunity and blessing to meet Mother Teresa in person, like I am seeing you today. In many Sunday evening prayer mass, I sat close to her feet for prayers. One evening, I gathered up enough courage to ask her, "Dear Mother, we are making so much progress in science and technology and everything else, but we keep encountering the same problem, or worse. Can you help me?" She says, our brain is making those progress. Our brain is getting smarter, but our heart is simply not catching up. My dear friends, I have a very simple and yet dynamic and achievable plan for the community. Let me tell you, that statement that I heard from Mother Teresa in Calcutta electrifies me each and every day. I get up and go to work, and that is how I have created these jobs in this community. And I do have a very simple yet dynamic and practical plan for our community and for our state. Actually, I believe in my heart, this is a plan for the future of your children and mine. I will introduce term limit and limit my own thought in the Jyoti Assembly. Hope Scholarship is very dearest to all of us. I passionately fought for Hope Scholarship in last time I ran. So when elected, I plan on proposing online lottery cell for the Hope Scholarship. You know, our VSU, Wiregrass State, Georgia Military College, if we want to see the continuous growth of these two, the three or four great institutions, Hope Scholarship got to be able to continue. And I believe if we introduce online lottery itself, that will triple the fund of Hope Scholarship very immediately. And if anybody is interested, I will be more glad to talk more about this. And I want to promise you, on legislative issues, I will vote based on the issue and people and matters that more important to South Georgia, not alone on the political party affiliation. I'll reach across the aisle to work hard to decrease taxes for small business owners and farmers. I'm a small business owner myself. I'm very worried about the future of this Air Force Base. I treat a lot of combat wounded soldiers. I treat a lot of veterans. I plan on reaching out to all members of Congress from Georgia and ask them to set up a dialogue with the military council of this chamber. So together, we can tell the federal government they need to leave alone our Air Force Base for any future reduction or any future cut for that purpose. Quite frankly, I will have better access to the federal government when I am elected in this matter comparing to my opponent. Last but not least, well, the reason I said that this administration is going to stay for 2-3 more years. So we don't know what's going to happen to the West in those times. Last but not least, I believe teachers are the backbone of our society. I will take $1 salary and let the governor give the remaining of the money for the betterment of public education in South Georgia. Because I see every day how teachers struggle. They get up 6 o'clock in the morning and get back home. They still have to grade papers. I speak to my children's teacher every day. I drop them off in the school. They work long hours. They have not seen a raise for 7 to 8 years. You know, Albert Einstein said, the problem that was created by the mindset can never be solved with the same mindset. Say this with all respect. I want you to know, I have a backbone. It may bend for the right reason, it will never break. When it comes to representing you, not Atlanta. I'm going to leave you with one thought. If you really want different results, you must take different actions. Voting for Vikram Mohanji will be that different action. With all humility, I'm asking your vote. God bless you and God bless America.